Saxena, editor, Aviation and Defense Universe, with our European and Middle East Bureau Chief, Chitali Bhatt, and we are here at a different place altogether at Bangkok, covering and getting you live Defense and Security 2022. This is day one at the show, and guess who we have here? We have the Indian ambassador to Thailand, and the lady is absolutely Indian, Mrs. H.E.Suchitra Durai. And ma'am, most welcome to ADU's chat room. It's wonderful to have you here, and it's so good to see an Indian representation with women power. So it's wonderful. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Sangeeta ji, for your very warm welcome. A pleasure to talk to you.
Ma'am, we are here to this Defense and Security show, and we'd really like to understand, since you've been at the helm of affairs guiding India-Thai relations, what is India-Thai relations like when it comes to foreign affairs?
We have a relationship which is trouble-free and which goes back a very long time. This year we're celebrating the 75th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic relations between India and Thailand. But what we have is a relationship which goes back millennia. And it is a relationship which is based on three pillars: the religious, the cultural, and the linguistic links, which form the basis of our relationship. And if you take all these three aspects also, how is it that all these ideas and these philosophies got exchanged and shared between India and Thailand? It's because of trade. We are Indian Ocean neighbors. In fact, Thailand is India's maritime neighbor. Trade and commerce is really the focus of our relationship. It has grown in the last few decades, and the contemporary relationship is truly multifaceted. So we have excellent political exchanges at the very highest levels. We have very good, strong trade and investment relationship. Our bilateral trade crossed $15 billion last year, in fact, during the COVID-19 period, which indicates that there is huge potential for even more. We have a very strong cultural relationship. We have very good people-to-people contacts, trade, educational exchanges, and tourism. Before COVID-19 began in 2019, India is one of the biggest sort of catchment area for Thai tourism. 1.9 million Indian tourists visited Thailand. And of course, the reverse flow is not as impressive. We had only about 160,000 Thais who visited India. But we are hoping that this will really increase now. And after both Thailand and India opened up in 2022, we in fact became the number one foreign country in terms of foreign tourists into Thailand. So, there's a lot of interest in India. India has great goodwill here, very good soft power in many ways, and it's also very much respected in terms of science and technology, particularly in the area of information technology, space, etc. And of course, I can speak on defense and security, but you may wish to ask a question.
Yes, ma'am, absolutely. Yes. Actually, before passing on to defense and security, we very recently had our foreign minister here. And what was all that about? It was wonderful. It created a lot of news in India and everywhere else. So we'd like to discuss that with you. How did it influence the already good ties which we have between India and Thailand?
It is a very important visit that we had from our External Affairs Minister. It was in the context of the 9th India-Thailand Joint Commission meeting. We have this mechanism, which is co-chaired by the foreign ministers on both the sides. So the Deputy Prime Minister and the Foreign Minister of Thailand, Mr. Don Pramod Vinay, co-chaired it from Thailand side, and External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jayashankar co-chaired it from the Indian side. It's an opportunity for us to go through the entire spectrum of our bilateral relations. So a review was held of all aspects. Apart from these meetings, ex-Prime Minister also called on the Prime Minister of Thailand, had a very good exchange, and in addition, of course, also paid visits to various points of very great importance, including the Grand Palace, which has very important murals which reflect the Ramayana. And also he visited to the Devasthana, which is the temple, the Brahmin temple, which is used by the royal Brahmins of Thailand, and that again is a very important area of our connect, cultural and religious connect over centuries. And apart from this, very important public engagement at the Chulalongkorn University of Thailand, which is the number one public university, where he gave a public lecture on India's vision of the Indo-Pacific. As everyone is aware, both India and Thailand are, of course, part of the Indo-Pacific. And the ASEAN outlook on the Indo-Pacific was adopted by ASEAN during Thailand's chairmanship in 2019. And it's very similar and shares many commonalities with India's own vision of the Indo-Pacific. So our PM, Dr. S. Jaishankar's lecture was an open lecture. So you had students, faculty members of the university and other universities, apart from this, think tanks, people from the diplomatic corps, all of them followed this thing, and it made a huge impact. And ma'am, my next question would be about, how are the defense and security ties between India and Thailand, and how do such exhibitions enhance the quality of good existing ties? We have a very robust defense and security cooperation. The framework for this is, of course, the MOU which was signed between India and Thailand in 2012. Which provides the framework for these exchanges. So under that, we have regular exchanges of visits. There is a defense dialogue mechanism, which is led by senior officials of the Ministry of Defense, and which has, of course, as part of its membership, representatives from the armed forces on both sides. We have regular exercises. We have a coordinated patrol exercise, which is undertaken by the Royal Thai Navy and the Indian Navy. So every 6 months we have an exercise in the Andaman coast. Our ships visit Thai ports regularly. In addition, we have the Siam Bharat exercise, which is done by the air forces of both sides. That is a tabletop exercise, and we're looking at upgrading it with assets. In addition, we have the Maitri exercise, which is done by the two armies, in addition we have service to service staff talks, and of course training exchanges. We offer a lot of slots in our training establishments under the ITEC program, the Indian Technical and Economic Cooperation program, which is the flagship program of the Ministry of External Affairs, under which these training exchanges are done. And of course, the Thai side also offers slots in its prestigious institutions. So we have, at any given point, we have somebody who here who is training at the National Defense College here in Thailand, and other senior training establishments also we have people coming in and training. So these are roughly the kind of exchanges that we have. In addition, we have also at the level of the National Security Council of Thailand and India's own security establishments, we have exchanges. We have joint task force on maritime security, on judicial and legal cooperation, which meets from time to time. We have, of course, a mutual, a legal assistance treaty in criminal matters, the MLAT, which has been functioning very well. Also, we are in the process of having one in civil matters as well. We have extradition treaty, which I myself in some way was involved in the final negotiations when I was Joint Secretary in Delhi, looking after such matters. So we have the mechanisms in place for both for defence as well as security. security. There's a lot of interest on both sides to enhance our cooperation, and it is happening in practice. We are very happy with the kind of exchanges we have. But we would very much like to take it to the next higher level.
Absolutely, ma'am. That's wonderful, actually. And my last question to you, ma'am, would be that both India and majorly the Indian Ocean, which is the cynosure of all eyes as far as geopolitics of the world is concerned. Now, what I just wanted to understand is, where does Indo-Thai relationship stand in enhancing its geopolitical value as far as the global geopolitics is concerned?
Like I mentioned to you, the Indian vision for the Pacific shares a lot of similarities with the ASEAN outlook of the Indo-Pacific, of which, of course, Thailand, being the chair of ASEAN in 2019, was very much in the forefront of devising that. So we actually see eye to eye in terms of the Indo-Pacific itself. Very recently, under the Quad Vaccine Partnership, in fact, India donated 200,000 vaccines, made in India vaccines, to Thailand under that partnership. We are both part of the Indo-Pacific Business and Economic Framework, which has just been launched. So, these are all aspects in which we see we have a very similar approach to it. Naturally, what has happened is that Southeast Asia, there is a lot of the need for a strategic equilibrium is there for all countries. India is looked upon as a force for stability, as a force for peace, and as a very reliable partner in terms of trade and commerce. We have been here culturally for a very long, long time. So I think in all these aspects, Thailand sees India as a very important and as a reliable partner. And for India itself, Thailand is a very important and a very valued partner in Southeast Asia. We are both building this India-Myanmar-Thailand trilateral trade. Once that is implemented, and it is of great interest to both the sides, it will be really a game changer in the region, because we will have full economic integration between India and Southeast Asia. Recently, we also did a very major outreach in terms of the Northeast India, which we see again as the gateway to Southeast Asia. We had our second edition of the Northeast India Festival here in Thailand. So all these aspects bring both our countries together, and we do see eye to eye between ASEAN and India. ASEAN centrality is very important to India, and Thailand is a very important actor in ASEAN.
Thank you very much, ma'am. I'm honored to have you here with us, and we're really looking forward, that next time when we meet, we really find there's a great advancement to the already existing one we have between the two countries, and defense and aerospace remain fields where we really feel we have a great way to go, and we are marching. Thank you for being with us, ma'am. Our pleasure to have you.